It is a medical intervention that's never been tried before. Canadian and American scientists teaming up to deliver urgent care to a young killer whale. As Briar Stewart reports, the very future of West Coast orcas could be at stake.
In this video taken last month, the 3.5-year-old orca known as J50 swims alongside her mother. They are two of the remaining southern resident whales, a group that's critically endangered. Scientists know she's malnourished because they've tracked her development through aerial photos, and they also fear she's very sick.
At this point in time, we don't have accurate diagnostics. You can just sort of imagine the logistics of trying to figure out what's wrong with a whale from a distance and a whale that you don't actually even observe that often.
But there's a desperate effort underway to save her. Scientists from the U.S. and Canada are trying to take what's being called an unprecedented step. They plan to get as close as they can to the whale and use a dart to inject antibiotics, all while trying not to disturb the rest of the pod.
We're now down to 75 whales in this population, and we just can't afford to lose another female from this population because they really are so essential.
Over the past few days, the scientists were hampered by poor weather. What makes it more complicated is that these whales swim back and forth between waters in the U.S. and in Canada. While the Americans could move ahead with the antibiotic plan right away, if the whale was in Canadian waters, the scientists had to hold off until today, when the government issued special permits allowing them to act.
Human intervention is something that we bring to the table only as a measure of last resort. We don't really want to be playing God with Mother Nature.
Peter Ross is head of research with the Vancouver Aquarium. He says because the southern residents are endangered, governments have to be diligent about letting scientists get close.
In a perfect world where habitat is clean, the ocean is free from noise and disturbance, and there's abundance of food, these killer whales would be doing just fine, thank you very much.
But they're not, which is why two countries are going to great lengths now to try and save a whale whose entire population is under threat. Briar Stewart, CBC News, Vancouver.
The same pod of whales was dealt a tragedy just a few weeks ago when a newborn calf died. The mother has been struggling to keep it afloat for 16 days and refuses to let go. Experts describe it as an extraordinary display of grief and say it takes an incredible effort, so they're worried about the mother's health as well. Orcas in general are not listed as endangered, but this particular group is by both the U.S. and Canada. The southern resident killer whales live in the waters off B.C. and Washington State. Their numbers have dwindled to just 75 and counting.
First and foremost, a very special population that a lot of people care about. Three major conservation threats.
One big threat is insufficient food. Their biggest staple by far is Chinook salmon, and competition from humans has taken a toll. Another big problem, noise.
We increasingly recognize that these animals require a healthy acoustic environment underwater, and that's not always the case. These are busy waters, lots of vessels, recreational as well as commercial.
The whales use their calls to communicate and to hunt, and noise pollution can hamper both. The Port of Vancouver has been studying noise and has asked vessels to honour a voluntary speed limit in late summer. A third major threat, pollution. Canada has moved to regulate some contaminants, and over the past 30 years, the concentrations found in whales have been declining.
That's good news, but these are persistent chemicals. They weaken the immune system. They make animals more vulnerable to disease, and we still see the southern residents as among the most polluted whales on the planet.
Another threat used to be the capture of orcas for display in marine parks. About 50 years ago, 45 orcas were taken from here, and about a dozen were killed in the process. That is no longer allowed.
Here's a look at what else we're working on tonight.